Now, this goes for anything we do in North Atlanta. You don't just go. It's kind of rude, right? So I like to make contact just in a kind of a gentle, respectful manner. I'm like, here's her sacrum, right? Here's her tailbone down here, top of her sacrum. Sacrum is shaped sort of like a wedge, mm-hmm. right? More narrow at the south end, wider at the north end. We'll use lay people's language. Okay. So a nice way to make contact with it is just to put my hand on top of it. Now, if my hand's over here, I'm on her hip bone and her bum, right? I want to be right in the middle. And don't let blue jeans seams confuse you, because they might not be lined up. So don't go with the seaming, go with what you feel. And here's your sacrum. I'm going to just place my hand right on top. I'm going to support that with my other hand. And notice, I have a nice open angle here, right? If you bring it to a right angle and press down, you're going to hurt your wrist. So keeping it open, like so, I'm going to gently press her sacrum towards the table. That feel okay?
Mm-hmm.
Would you like more pressure?
Maybe a tiny bit.
Tiny bit. See, that's how I found out. I let her tell me. So. And it feels spongy here. I'm just going to hang out and wait for my teeth to get oily. You know, for
whatever.
I'm being pushed out. I'm being excused. That is a general release for the sacrum. Okay? General all-purpose utility release for the sacrum. And it's a good one to use if you find that the sacrum is kind of stuck and doesn't move a lot. But now I want to look at other movements that the sacrum can make and see what we can do. Now, one of those movements, if this is the sacrum, is it can shift away from me or towards me in this plane of movement. See that?
Mm-hmm.
So I'm going to put my hands on the sacrum. I can do it this way. I could use the heels of my hand, which I often do. Whatever contact feels natural and comfortable. And I'm going to push it away from me and notice how that is. Does it move easily or do I feel resistance? Wow. See how easily it moves?
Mm-hmm.
Now I'm going to check the other direction. I'm going to take the heel of my hand and I'm going to pull it towards me.
What about going on the other side of the
Will
table?
Will you wait? Okay, you have a camera here.
Oh, okay.
Okay, so I'm showing this. But
okay.
You certainly could go around the other side of the table and push away as well.
Okay.
But because we have a camera.
Okay,
and I can also do it fairly easily. I can do this.
Okay.
If the table was really wide, I might need to. But anyway, I want you to notice, when I pull her sacrum towards me, it really doesn't go anywhere. When I push away, all day. I'm guessing this is comfortable?
Very.
Okay. The position where you see the most movement is almost always going to be the position of greatest comfort. But you can always ask your partner, because they have the best view. They live in that body. They know more than you do about their body. They just know, always know that. And I'm waiting for heat, pulsing, or thank you, your excuse. There it is, pushing me out. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
So that re-education, just a little rocking, gentle rocking.
So were your palms down right in the center of her sacrum when you were...
Yeah. Actually, when I was pushing away from me, I would say that the heel of my hand was slightly off-center, my side, so I had something to push. And then when I pulled, I was slightly on the other side to push.
Okay.
So let's just see what happened there. Now, we know it likes to do this. Oh, look at that. Now it's regained some balance in that plane of movement. Okay? So now I'm going to look at another movement that I call tipping. So like if this is the sacrum and I push down on one side, the other side comes up, just like a teeter-totter, right? Push on the other side, conversely the other side comes up. So I want to check which side of her sacrum likes to be pushed down towards the table more. Which one offers the greatest ease of movement, greater comfort. So again, this is the middle. Don't let the seam fool you. This is the middle. I'm going to go just on the other side of the middle, heel of my hand, I'm going to press down towards the table. Guess what? Not having it. So I'm going to go to the other side and press down. Oh, see that? Little tiny bit of movement?
Mm-hmm.
And this is more comfortable, right?
Yeah.
So I'm going to press down on the side of her sacrum that offered the most movement. I'm exaggerating the tab.
What if there's no movement?
Then I would move it. I'd do the general release, which is exaggerating no movement, right? If it doesn't move, don't move it more. Mm-hmm. Is that sacrum comfortable?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, I'm just going to hang out and wait again for releasing. Just pushing it up and out.
She's got the best view of the body. She's got the 24/7 view, and she has a more complete view. So I'm always going to do what feels better for her. So you're saying that's good?
Yeah,
or this?
That's
okay. Okay, so there you go. We give her what she likes. So honestly, this is great. You know, you do either or, and whatever they like, that's what you do.
She's breathing.
Pushing me out.
I'm a well-trained orthoband body.
She is the ortho-educated body. So, does this feel better for you?
Mm-hmm.
Equal movement. Now, the last thing I want to look at is cranial caudal movement. Caudal is towards the tail. Cranial is towards the head. And this movement isn't a straight it's more like you're rolling your hand over a ball. There's a roundedness to this movement. So I'm going to check. How's it feel going towards your tail? How's it feel coming? Oh, that's my movement coming towards your head.
And as before last time, it feels better going the way that there's less movement. Caudally.
You know what? I didn't hear a word you said.
Caudally.
You
feels
like
better.
Going towards your tail?
Yeah.
Okay, good. So I could stand here and do this, but I know a lot of you like to work from the head of the table too. I could also go up here and support it like that. And then I'm using my body weight to do it. I'm leaning down my arm. I have a nice open angle here. Or I could just stand here and do it. I'm not using like 1,000 pounds of pressure here.
Actually feels better when you do it from the side.
Okay, great. Oh, it's pushing me out. There we go. Nice, going towards your head.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Those are the general releases for the sacrum. I'm going to review them. You could just play it where it lays. Compress it straight down wherever it is. And if it doesn't move much, Diane, that would be how I would start. Usually after you do that, it'll be able to express a little bit more movement. And then we can check in no particular order. There's nothing magic about the order. Moving away from us or towards us. Tipping one way or the other way. Twisting one way, twisting the other way, going towards your feet, going towards your head. Okay, any questions about that? Okay, now I want to show you how to release individual points, okay, around the sacrum. These general releases, if done first, will clear out most of the tension in the area. And then you can go back and check for points of sensitivity. And again, if you remember that picture of the sacrum, I'm going to just touch around the edge of the sacrum, mm-hmm. starting at her tailbone. Any place that's sensitive, you let me know. Right here? Okay, this is sensitive. So, one way to release it is what's called the tilt plate method. It doesn't want to be pushed down. If I push down, she says...
I feel that.
Okay, she says out. Okay,
So if this point doesn't want to be pushed down, after what we talked about in the info dump, which way does it want to go?
Up.
Up. How do I do that? I go to the other side of the sacrum, and I press down, and I feel the point being lifted. That's the tilt plate. Okay? And now I'll recheck. Is it still sensitive?
Not really.
I guess not. Okay. So this is working for her, so I'm going to hang out and wait for a rebound, or a pulse, or heat, or the elevator going down, or the big, there's the big breath. Okay, we're done. Okay. Now we'll recheck. Has it changed?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Notice I don't say, is it better? I ask, has it changed? I'm looking for change. Better might be later today. It'll cook for a while. Hasn't necessarily read the whole email. Let's say this didn't work. Let's see if I can find another point that might like some attention, and I'll show you the other way.
There you go.
There?
Uh-huh.
Okay. So the other way we can release it is making a cave around it, sort of. And I'm going to do that by lifting from her hip towards the point to make it soft. Notice that my legs are right next to the table. I'm going to go and lift up her hip. I'm going to pull towards this point. I'm going to lean my body back. And that's going to perform the lift. I'm not doing it with my bicep. So, like that. I'm hang gliding here off the table. I have a fulcrum here. I'm going to check. Is it changed?
Not really.
Not really. That's okay.
Okay.
Sometimes you lift from the same side, and sometimes you lift from the opposite side. So I am going to go around to the other side of the table. And I'm going to lift from the opposite side and see if that does the job. I'm going to switch hands. This hand's going to monitor. I'm going to again lift the opposite hip towards that point. And how's that now?
A little better.
Okay, so we've got the right position. I'm going to hang out and wait for her body to tell me it got the email. It's pulsing. Okay, didn't take long at all. So, how does that feel now?
Better.
Okay, it's okay if the client says better, but I recommend that you don't use that better word. And the reason is, most people believe that better means completely better. And sometimes it changes, but it's not better. And if you say, is it better, they expect that you're going to make it better, and they'll have you all day trying to make it better. So we look for change. You educate your client that you're looking for change, and that way you don't paint yourself into a corner with the B word. Alrighty. So, those are the techniques that we use for the sacrum. We do the general release first, straight down, check, shift, shift, tip, tip, twist, twist, tail, head, and then we can go around the edges of the sacrum and look for anything that's sensitive. You won't find a lot, and then you can release that by tilt plate. Go to the opposite side, push down to lift it up. Or you can lift the opposite side towards the point. Or you can lift the same side towards the point. Whatever works. Any questions about that? Okay, find somebody to play with.